Hello everyone, myself Halunda SS. Today we are going to discuss related to analog circuit, in that our previous lecture is related to non-sinusoidal oscillators. As a part of that non-sinusoidal oscillator, today's topic is related to multivibrators. Now let us see about that multivibrators. First of all, we are going to see what is the definition of that multivibrator. That means what is the meaning of that multivibrator and all these things we are going to see. A multivibrator is an electronic circuit that is used to implement two state system like oscillators, timers and flip-flops. That means it is used to respond for the two state system, that is for that oscillators, timers and flip-flops. It is characterized by two amplifying devices, that is a transistor or other devices. That means it is formed by using two amplifying devices such as a transistor or other devices. Crosses the coupled by the resistor or capacitor, or it will be crosses the resistor, capacitor or any kind of a devices. Then for the invention of that multivibrator, where that multivibrator is invented, just we are going to see. Henry Abraham and Eugene Bloch described the first multivibrator circuit in 1920, also called as a plot-coupled multivibrator. Just see, here is the images related to that multivibrator. That multivibrator, the idea came in your mind, that how much big that multivibrator is, it looks like. It is a vacuum tube Abraham Bloch multivibrator oscillator, which is invented in France in 1920. It was made from vacuum tube and its harmonics are being used to collaborate a wave meter. That means whatever the harmonics generated by that multivibrator, that harmonics is collaborated with that wave meter. And that wave meter will be generates whatever the output introduced by that system. Then classification of the multivibrator, it is one important thing. There are three types of multivibrator circuits depending upon the circuit operation. First one is a stable, that means neither state is a stable. That means for a stable multivibrator, there are two states are present related to multivibrator. But for the unstable multivibrator, there is no any kind of a state is a stable. That means both states are unstable, not a stable. Then monostable, for that one of the state is a stable but other is a not. That means either first or second state is a stable related to monostable multivibrator and other is a not. Then next is a bistable multivibrator. In that, it remains is either state is identified. Means what? Bistable multivibrator stages, both the states remains stable in this case. First of all, we are going to see one by one in detail. The C over here, first is a stable multivibrator. A multivibrator that generates a square wave without using an external triggering pulse is known as a stable multivibrator. That means multivibrator is one of the part of oscillator, and we know very well what is the function of oscillator. Oscillator will be generates the signals without applying any kind of input to that oscillator. That function is also carried out in our multivibrator. That means multivibrator is one of the device that is generate that output signal without giving or applying any kind of a input to that multivibrator. But input is not only input is related to that non-sinusoidal signals. That means so whatever the signal is introduced by that multivibrator is not sine wave, other waves are introduced by that multivibrator. It is also known as a pre-running multivibrator. That means no any kind of a stable state is available related to a stable multivibrator. For that purpose, this type of a multivibrator is called as a free running multivibrator. In that pre running multivibrator, how that look like? That is the input. A stable multivibrator now provided over here. This is a circuit diagram. Then what is the output introduced by that unstable multivibrator? That is a T1 state and that is a T2 state. T1 state, if zero input time period is applied, then it is a act towards that ground level. If one input is given to that particular system, then act it is act in a positive higher level. If suppose zero input is given to that system, then it acts towards the downward level, that is ground level. And if suppose one is applied, then it is again acting in a higher level. Like this 0 1 0 1, this type of a situation we have considered over here for the time period T1 and T2. Then the output looks like this, and this output is generated by that unstable multivibrator. Along with that unstable multivibrator, this is previously we have discussed related to unstable multivibrator. It is a basic logic idea related to that unstable multivibrator. But here we are going to discuss circuit diagram of unstable multivibrator. What that circuit diagram shows us that this unstable circuit consists of the two transistor across the coupled feedback network. Just see here, transistor Q1 is used over here. Here transistor Q2 is used here. Coupling means what? Output of the first system is connected as an input to second system, or input of first system is output of second system is connected as an input of first system. Like this, here we have coupled the transistor Q1 and Q2 feedback network and two capacitors and the four resistors. Just see over here, RL1 and RL2, these are the two resistors along with R1 and R2. That means here we have used four resistors which are connected parallel with each other, and two capacitors. Just see over here, C1 and C2, both the capacitors are connected for both the transistor base across, and that values related to that capacitor is that capacitors are also connected in parallel with each other, and thus here the unstable multivibrator is formed, and the voltage across that transistor Q1 is measured by using the letter, that is a VC1. That means the voltage measured across the collector of the transistor Q1 is VC1, and for the transistor Q2 is VC2. And VCC is a commonly applied by commonly connecting network, coupling that network by using VCC, and remaining terminals are connected towards that ground by using VEE. This is the basic structure related to our unstable multivibrator. Just see over here, it is a C1, this is C2. Okay. Then unstable multivibrator, consider transistor Q1 is an on and Q2 is a off. Then what happened? VCC drops the across RL1, hence the VC1 is a 0. Just see here, over here, drops here, and the point A is in a ground potential, and a VC2 is equal to VCC. That is a C1 is a discharging and C2 is a charging. Just look like over here. What it looks like, that is a just see here VC1. What happened in that VC1? VC1 is an increasing or dropout that output voltage, that is a V on period is a slowly charging, and VCC goes on slowly decreasing. This is a time period or time gap in between VCC and V on. Then again it will be gross dropped out across that RL2. And what happened in that RL2? It is a slowly goes on increasing, and this is a spike like for that output we are going to observing over here. Along with that stable multivibrator, condition is a reversed, that is a Q2 is on and Q1 is off. Then what happens? That VCC drops across L2, and hence VC2 is a 0. For that Q1 on, L1 is a dropped out and VC1 is a equal to 0. And but here the total condition is a opposite. Point B is at a ground potential and VC1 is equal to VCC. C2 discharging and C1 is a charging. And for Q1, C1 is a charging, C1 is a discharging and C2 is a charging, opposite to that condition. And just see over here, this is a diagrammatical representation for this condition, and this is a drop down procedure related to for that reference T level. Apart from that reference T level, it is a dropped out, that VC2 is also dropped out and VB2 is also dropped out over here. Then unstable multivibrator, for the unstable multivibrator VC1, VB1, VC2 and VB2. Just see over here that unstable multivibrator purpose VC1 and VC2, it is increasing towards that ground level potential, which is totally opposite to each other. If suppose here is a zero level is a present, then here is a one level is a present. If suppose the one level is a present, then here is a zero level is a present. If suppose here a zero level is present, then here is a one level is present. That means these two conditions are totally opposite to each other. That means there is no any kind of the stable state is available over here. Similarly for VB1 and VB2, we are going to observing, just see here. Here no any kind of a sawtooth is a present like structure, and here sawtooth is a present, and here also sawtooth is a present. Here is no kind of any kind of a sawtooth is present. Here is a plain structure, here is a sawtooth structure is available. Like this, VB1 and VB2 are going to exhibit in. For that unstable multivibrator, for the time being, the time constant, that is a T1, is a measured, that is a one third period. One third period is a 0.69 R1C1, 0.69 R2C2, like this 0.69 R3C3. Like this, for Q1 it is goes on increasing, and for Q2, that is a if suppose here is a rising period is a present, then here is obviously falling period is a present. If suppose here is a falling period is a present, then here we are going to use that rising period. Here is a rising period, then here we are going to use that falling period. Like this period goes on changes. That is a time constant T1 is used over here, and here the time constant T2 is used over here. Now for that unstable multivibrator, frequency of oscillations, it can be proved that off time of Q1 is T1 is equal to 0.69 R1C2, and for the Q2 is T2 is equal to 0.69 R2C2. Hence the total time period of the wave is T is equal to T1 plus T2 for transistor Q1 as well as transistor Q2. By adding these two terminology, what we get, 0.69 terminology is a constant from each factor, here R1C2 plus here R2C1. If R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R, and C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C, that is the two stages are symmetrical, then T is equal to, what happened in that T, just we are replacing that R1C2 and R2C1 by plain R and C components. What is the equating value came over here? Here R1 RC present, here RC present, 1 RC is equal to 2 RC. That 2 RC is a multiplied by 0.69. what is the value came into picture? That is a 0.69 multiplied by 2. What is that value came into picture? That is a 1.38 RC, and this is the total time period related to that unstable multivibrator. It is a given by the reciprocal of the time period, just I have shown over here. It is a reciprocal of the time period, and that we know very well frequency time relation. That frequency is a totally opposite to that time, and time is totally opposite to frequency. Like this, there is a change in the frequency and time period. That is, f is equal to 1 by t and t is equal to 1 by f. And we know what is the value of t. T is equal to 1.38 RC. Like this, we have put out the value of t. That t is equal to 1.38 RC is equal to 0.7 RC. That means for multiplying and adjusting the value related to 1.1 divided by 1.38, like 0.7 divided by RC, and here we are getting the measurable value related to frequency calculation for unstable multivibrator. Then applications of that unstable multivibrator. Unstable multivibrator is used in many more applications. First of all, we are going to discuss related to that unstable multivibrator application is, it is used in applications where low clock frequency clock pulses trends is required. That means whenever we are using that low clock pulses and low frequency of that clock pulses, then there we are going to use that unstable multivibrator. Then relaxation oscillator, which are the part of a vehicle, indicator lights, earlier oscilloscope and television receivers. That means relaxation oscillator is nothing but non-sinusoidal oscillators, and that non-sinusoidal oscillators are nothing but multivibrators, and that multivibrators are used in a vehicle indicator lights, early oscilloscope, television receivers, etc. For these kind of application, we are going to use a stable multivibrator along with timing signal is also used in that stable multivibrator. Then next, second part related to multivibrator is a monostable multivibrator. Then what is the definition of that monostable multivibrator? Just see over here, definition: a multivibrator which has a one state, one stable state and one temporary quasi stable state, and the level transmission depend upon the external triggering pulses is also known as monostable multivibrator. That means here permanently one stable state is a present and another state is not permanently stable. It is a quasi stable state, means what? Temporary stable state. Then that type of a multivibrator is called as a monostable multivibrator. In that monostable multivibrator, if suppose input T1 is applied, that is a sawtooth like structure is applied to that circuit, that circuit is related to monostable multivibrator signal, then T1 is acting as a, here is a 0, here is a 1 present plus VCC, and it is again acted towards that 0 value, then it will be introduces the whatever the output introduced by that monostable multivibrator, that output is having one stable state and one is a variable state. Then monostable multivibrator circuit, in that monostable multivibrator circuit, C2 is applied towards that Q1 and C1 is applied towards that Q2. Just see over here, for that monostable multivibrator, apart from that every stable multivibrator, one change is done over here. Instead of R1 connecting parallel with that R2, RL1 and RL2, here that R1 is connected in a series with that transistor based connection, and only one capacitor is used over here, and another capacitor is connected towards that base from that input supply. Like this, the changes is this change, like this only the changes made over here. Just see over here, I have shown over here, this is one change and this is another change related to the connection of that stable multivibrator, and for this circuit also. And for the monostable multivibrator, what is the application running over here, or how that circuitry work will be work, just we are going to see here. When the circuit is switched on, the transistor Q1 will be off and Q2 will be on. Means what? Here first of all we are considering that Q2 is on and Q1 is off. The capacitor C1 gets charged during this state. That means similarly for that stable multivibrator, there also the capacitor C1 is charged and C2 is discharged. Like this, here also that C1 gets charged and C2 is discharged. When a positive triggering is applied to the base of the transistor Q1, it turns on, which turns off the transistor Q2, and that transistor Q2 base is applied towards that RL1 resistor, and that resistor is connected across a series connection with respect to that RL1, RL2 and R2, and R1 is connected series. Okay, then our next target is related to monostable multivibrator. Capacitor C1 state discharging during this state, and the transistor Q1 remains in on state due to positive voltage from the collector, and the transistor Q2 which is in a off state. Transistor Q2 remains in the off state until the capacitor C1 discharges completely. When the capacitor C1 discharges completely, the transistor Q1 turns on, which turns transistor Q1 off. That means here we are going to see, for the monostable multivibrator, one state is a stable and another state is a stable. For that purpose, it means it act as a stable, like this. That means it is not stable in a condition, it is a quasi stable state. For that quasi stable state, it is not fixed for that purpose. Then next is a monostable multivibrator. Applications related to that monostable multivibrator is, monostable multivibrators are used in analog system to control an output signal frequency. That means it is used to control that frequencies related to that monostable multivibrator systems, and to synchronize the line and frame rate of television broadcasts, to hold the output voltage in its unstable state for a certain period of a time, to moderate the tunes of different octaves with the electronic augers. Then bistable multivibrator. It is a third and last type related to our multivibrator. What is the definition of that bistable multivibrator? In name itself indicate that it is a having two stable states. That is a multivibrator that has a two absolute stable state and can stay in a one of the two states identifiably is known as bistable multivibrator. It changes its state when it gets triggering pulses and stay in that state until it gets another triggering pulses. Just see over here, bistable multivibrator. For that bistable multivibrator, it is the input applied to that bistable multivibrator transistor T1, and for the T2, it is a Q1. That is a circuitry applied for that bistable multivibrator. It is related to plus VCC, and plus VCC here we are going to use at the output. That is a transistor Q1 and Q2, which is acting as an input related to transistor rising time period, that is a T1, and transistor falling time period, it is a T2. Just shown over here, just observe that circuit diagram related to bistable multivibrator is shown over here. That is a R2 and R2. This is a R2 and R2. That is a VC1 and VB2. VC2 is a connected over here. This is the circuit diagram of bistable multivibrator. When VCC is applied, one transistor will start conducting slightly more than that of the other. Let Q2 be on and Q1 be off. Then that means the condition is reversed over here. When the Q2 is on, the potential at the collector of the Q2 decreases, which is termed will decreases the potential at the bias of Q1. Due to the potential divider action of R1 and R2, the potential at the collector of the Q1 increases, in the turn further increases the base of the emitter voltages and the base of Q2. The voltage at the collector of the Q2 further decreases, which is termed further reduces the voltage at the base Q1. This action will be continued till Q2 becomes fully saturated and Q1 becomes fully cut off. Thus, the stable state of binary is such that one device remains in a cutoff and other device remains at the saturation. It will be in that state until the triggering pulses is applied to it. It has two stable states. For every transistor transition of the state, triggering is required at a time only one device will be conducting. Bistable multivibrator. Here we are going to see what are the applications related to that bistable multivibrator. It is used for the performance of many digital operations such as counting and storing binary information. For that purpose we are going to use that bistable multivibrators. It is also used in the generation and the processing of the pulses type waveforms. It is widely used in the digital logic and computer memory also. Okay, this is all about related to multivibrators, that is a bistable, unstable and monostable multivibrators. That multivibrator is nothing but one of the type related to non-sinusoidal oscillator. Okay, thank you.